What's going on, y'all? I am Kofi, a.k.a. Mr. 24-7, and you are watching another episode of I Just Love Kicks. And today we have yet another special episode. Oh my God! Oh my God! Redo! Hold on. There it is. Yeah. Sometimes things just happen on the show and you just got to roll with it. You know, I'm sure the editors will make that look cool or replayed and you guys can get a laugh. But nonetheless, we are talking sneakers right now. And look, this is one of the boxes that you don't know what's in there because it's customized. My go-to sneaker is the Nike Presto. The Nike Presto has a surprising amount of arch support and they're breathable, they're lightweight. To me, they are the perfect sneaker. I have them in every, not every single colorway, but I got quite a bit. Count them, you see them. There it is, yeah. So Prestos are my sneaker. They actually came out with a new Presto. I don't mind new sneakers coming out, but if it ain't broke, don't fix it. They said they were gonna be changing the soles on them. I said, why are you changing what I like? Why are you changing what works for me? But then they said, oh, we're gonna put a React sole on the bottom. So I said, oh, now, well, maybe we're talking because the React sole is, you know, it just came out recently, but it's kind of like the equivalent, the Nike's equivalent of the Boost sole. Very comfortable, very light, bouncy, just magnifique. So if there ever was a sole to combine with the Presto, it would be the React sole. So without further ado, you see right there, you slide it open, you see the tissue right here. I believe these come with the Nike ID shoes. Go on Nike and you can customize your own sneakers. So that was another thing. When I saw like the images for these, they did like a little throwback, an homage to when the Prestos first came out in 2000. They were known for like being like the t-shirt shoe. You know, they had like t-shirt fabric on them. The sizes were like small, medium, large, extra large, like t-shirts were. So it was a unique campaign. They had these characters on them wanting to say like Bert the Bee, and that's not right because that's chapstick, but character driven type themes. The Presto went on to become one of the most comfortable shoes out there. So now here we are, the Presto React. I wasn't really feeling like the newer colorways that came out, even like the Lava one that came out. I liked it, but I just for some reason never pulled the trigger on it because I felt like I wouldn't have had anything to wear with it. So I customized it. Like they feel, get it out. They feel light, breathable material, all on the upper. The laces, kind of like a checkered pattern, red with a little bit of gray in them. I was a little upset that I couldn't just get like straight red. It wasn't an option at the time. I don't know if that's available on Nike ID right now. The updated cage on the side, and then the Nike check. As you can see, that swoosh. Of course, we have the React sole. On the insole here, these were the characters that I was talking about. This is the Kielbasa dude. Look at on the back of the heel. That's why I went to Nike ID. It says 24-7, and that's me, Mr. 24-7. If I wear these for a while and I'm feeling them, then I might make the transition from older Presto to the new. Which way are we gonna go? Put the soles back in, kind of reverse Shang Tsung there. Get it? Because I'm wearing a Goro shirt right now. Mortal Kombat.
And after having worn these Presto Reacts for almost 3 weeks, went to the gym with them, I wore them in everyday life, went to Comic-Con, walked around a little bit. I didn't quite feel the cushioning of the React as I did in the others. These also made my feet sweat a little bit more. The neoprene that they use on this is a little bit different. So one thing that I did like about these was the laces. And I know initially I said that I didn't like the fact that I couldn't customize them. I realized that these like checkers are actually like 3M. You get a cool little reflective effect when the light shines up against them. A great shoe, great sneaker, a lot of people will like them, but for me, I gotta stick with the original. Actually, ended up going on to Nike ID and ordering another custom pair of Prestos. Ordering these ones, Nike ID, they go for I think 140, and ordinarily you'd pay like 120 for a regular pair of Prestos just at the store or online. So I put 24 on the left and 7 on the right. Just for me, I prefer the original. That's what I'm going with. Out with the old and in with the new.
talk about this for super awkward. I am actually waiting for my Lyft driver to come, and I go to slide my Prestos on, and they're really, really tight, and I'm wondering if they, like, changed the sizing, and I go and look at my receipt, and I ordered it in a woman's size 10. So tight on my feet. Da 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 da